Come gather round, people, and turn up the tube, and we'll tell you a marvelous tale of medical hunches, restorative lunches, and rural deliveries of mail. Romantically comic, heartbreakingly tragic, it's really not either of these, but thoroughly true and a pinnacle too in the history of Limburger cheese.
In the Iowa village they call Independence, a farmer named Kaiser took sick. The year 35 had been slow to arrive, and the snow fell unusually thick. The rare diagnosis by Dr. McGreedy was chronic dyspeptic unease. Prognosis was fine if the farmer would dine on a smidgen of Limburger cheese.
Now Limburger cheese was the jewel of Wisconsin, the pride of the town of Monroe. And poor Mr. Kaiser lived over in Iowa, too far to ski through the snow. He posted a plea to the cheesemakers, urgently begging them, gentlemen, please. Here's 1 1/4, express me an order of curative Limburger cheese.
When Mr. Ralph Wenger, the company manager, heard of the farmer's travail, he made sure a block of their strongest concoction went out in the afternoon mail. But a sensitive Iowa mailman declared as he sniffed it and fell to his knees, "I never delivers what gives me the shivers, especially Limburger cheese."
And when Independence's postmaster W. Miller was brought up to date, he said, "Though my senses of factory offenses are reasonably ripe for debate, it seems this particular fragrance is sidelining one of my best employees. Although I've smelled worse, my employees come first. I'm returning this Limburger cheese."
Now little Monroe had a postmaster too, who'd step into the fray now and then. J. Burkhart felt strongly the cheese had been wrongly returned, and he mailed it again. But first he took pains to rewrap it in foil and in cardboard too sturdy to squeeze. And passing appraisal, both postal and nasal, away went the Limburger cheese.
But when it came home to Monroe once again, it took Postmaster Burkhart aback. Instead of completely accepting defeat, he developed a two-pronged attack. He mumbled, "I'll send it to Washington, then if the Postmaster General agrees. With approval attached, we'll rewrap and dispatch for the third time the Limburger cheese."
And meanwhile, Post Hasty composed an epistle to Postmaster Miller that read, "Yours truly proposes a contest of noses to bring this whole thing to a head. I'll sublet a centrally located hall, and I'll personally pay all the fees. I'll spring for the brew and the bakery too, and I'll pop for the Limburger cheese."
"I'm confident Postmaster Burkhart went on, though you shrink in our product's bouquet. I know you will savor its bountiful flavor and fling your embargo away. For once you do try it, you'll never deny it a passage to your addressees. And came the reply, I'm a reasonable guy, I will sample your Limburger cheese."
2:30 p.m. on the 9th day of March in Dubuque at the Julian Hotel. If you couldn't see, you could find Parlor B on the mezzanine level by smell, where cameras were raised and reporters were poised for a test of their best journalese. Expecting a thriller as Burkhart served Miller a sandwich of Limburger cheese.
Whilst everyone present was holding their breath, watching Miller prepare to consume, including the guests who'd been holding their breaths ever since they'd come into the room. He managed to nibble and then took a bite, and as crumbs tumbled down his chemise, the whole room went wild when the postmaster smiled and requested more Limburger cheese.
When word of this great vindication arrived in Monroe on the following day, and then the day after, to cheering and laughter, the Postmaster General's okay. The village went mad and demanded a plan to revive one of those jamborees. So popular here, full of bratwurst and beer, and afloat for Miss Limburger Cheese.
And so ends our tale, but those sagas like this are the stuff of a newspaper's dreams. Assuming it's true that she's finally went through, there is more to the story, it seems. For if there's an ironic twist at the end of this tale that began with disease, it's a postman made ill and a farmer made well by the same piece of Limburger cheese. A postman made ill and a farmer made well by the same piece of Limburger cheese.